Welcome to the new Sounds of J.W. Pepper, where we'll explore the newest music titles for school and church from the publishers and writers who create them. Each episode, we'll talk with a different publisher or writer about their top new releases for the coming year, along with behind-the-scenes stories and teaching tips that you wouldn't get anywhere else. In this episode, we're talking with Andy Beck, Director of Choral Publications at Alfred Music. A prolific composer and arranger, he has over 450 popular choral works, vocal resources, and children's musicals currently in print, including the highly regarded method books Sing at First Sight, Foundations in Choral Sight Singing, and Vocalize, 45 vocal warm-ups that teach technique. Andy is in demand as a guest conductor, choreographer, adjudicator, and clinician for educators and students throughout the United States and beyond. Andy is going to share some of his favorite new releases from the Alfred catalog for your consideration. Remember to check the YouTube description below, where we'll include links to all the pieces we're discussing today. Hello, Andy, and welcome to New Sounds.
Hi, it's so good to be here. Thank you for having me.
Well, it's our pleasure. We're excited to have you here with our new video series. So let's get started by talking a little bit about Alfred Music and what's been going on this year. So let's start with, what do you feel like Alfred's specialty is when it comes to choral music? What can teachers count on when they pick an Alfred piece for their concert?
Oh, that's a great question, and you're talking to the right guy because I love to talk about Alfred Music.
I figured.
There are a few things that come to mind. I hope that teachers can count on us for really quality writers, not only those that they know and love, but brand new ones coming to us all the time. Beautifully engraved editions that don't have mistakes or errors, are easy to get through in a rehearsal because they look so clean. And then as a choral editor, I'm very proud of what Alfred brings to the table editorially. That means, like, we're going to give you music that's free of roadblocks, that makes a great deal of sense, vocal parts that are enjoyable to sing, rewarding to sing, piano parts and accompaniments that really, really work. That's sort of what we're looking for from the technical side. But also, we really consider everything from a teacher and director's perspective when we select what music we're going to publish. So we're looking for things that are highly programmable. So whatever your yearly concert season is, hopefully Alfred has something for you. And no matter what age level or sort of whatever the level of your choir or whatever you're teaching, we've got something for you. So some of you teachers might know Alfred from that very first partner song that's teaching your elementary school kids to get into some harmony. Some of you might know us for that middle school repertoire that helps through the voice change, or an expressive poetic setting that really works on nuance for high schoolers, or all the way up to collegiate and community things. If you know the James Erb arrangement of Shenandoah in 8 parts, or awesome Alice Parker, Hark, I Hear the Harps Eternal, that's Alfred Music too. So we're really trying to have a broad view of the concert year and all the different type of choirs out there.
That's great. Yeah, a little bit of everything. I know when I think of Alfred, it's a little bit of everything.
That's sort of our goal, so I'm glad you said that.
So it's been a crazy year for all of us. Tell us a little bit about what it's been like for you and for Alfred, because we've all gone through some changes.
Yeah, well, I mean, we've seen at least a year of one of the scariest things for people to do is to get together and sing. So there hasn't been a lot of getting together and sing, and that's very much what our focus had been prior to the pandemic. But when we realized it was going to be a reality that choirs weren't going to be doing what they traditionally did, I got together with some of my fellow team members here at Alfred, and we thought, okay, what would help us continue music education but in a very different scenario? And we came up with some brand new ideas and put our focus on that as sort of a bridge to help us through that difficult year.
Yeah, and that leads perfectly into my next question. So what's new this year? I know you've got some new formats, some new, just new series, all kinds of different things. So give us a sneak peek.
Yeah, okay. So kind of what I was just referring to, yes, it led perfectly from the last question. We created a brand new product line that we never had before, which we call interactive slides. These are slide sets that come to a teacher in a Google format or PowerPoint with embedded audio. And if you're in editing mode, you can type answers into your computer. So they work really well for students who are working on their own, asynchronously, at their own devices. And as we transition back to traditional classrooms, I think they're going to be great to project at the front of the room as well. And we've got various things there. We've got warm-ups from my Vocalize series on slides and a new sight singing method called Sight Singing Workshop. We've got a wonderful choral builder called Choir Bites, some great music history resources like the Women of Western Music and Accent on Composers, lots of different things that are in a whole new format.
Yeah, and I especially like the fact that you took some of your tried and true, more the Accent on Composers and some of those resources that have been around for a while and really just kind of updated them and made them usable in that virtual environment. I really like how you guys jumped on that and saw that need. So that was really great. Okay, well, let's get started and hear about some of these new titles coming out this year.
I am so excited to share with you.
Great.
You know, we've published many, many titles. You asked me to come up with 10 that I had to present.
It's tricky.
But I'm so excited about these 10. I can't wait to talk about them.
Yay! All right, well, let's jump right into it. So the first one, Lift Your Voice and Rejoice.
Yes, well, as you could tell from the title, this is a very joyful, uplifting piece. It's by one of my favorite composers, Victor C. Johnson. Sort of a side note, a lot of us are trying to program more composers of color. This qualifies for that. But what I really love most about it is that Victor, who's been a wonderful choral conductor for much of his career, in addition to being a composer, he really infuses this with lots of show-off moments for a choir. So what I mean by that is it's got this glorious homophonic fanfare at the beginning, and then it breaks into a really rhythmic and kind of syncopated main theme, so choirs can really show off a different kind of style than they did in that fanfare. Eventually, in the middle of the piece, it slows down, and he gives us a very expressive setting of the Latin Gaudeamus Hodie, and even takes the time to stack voice parts one at a time through there, so each section sort of gets that independence that really helps them develop their own confidence as a section. And then, of course, he brings the fanfare back at the end with a couple of extra descant notes, which just make it a perfect concert opener, or if a choir has the opportunity to sing for adjudicators this year, you get to show off lots of skills with this piece.
Excellent. All right, let's take a listen. Amazing. I love that big, huge sound and those harmonies, really. But they're probably a lot easier than they sound.
Yeah, well,
I mean,
it's very traditional harmony. It's very resonant, lock the chords kind of things. And what's nice about it is even in the smaller voicings of three-part mixed or the treble version, the chords still ring.
Yeah. Oh, it's great. Perfect opener. I agree. All right. Let's move on to this next one. This is actually one of my favorites of your new releases this year. On You Stay 2020.
This is really a special piece. You know, Jay Althaus is not only one of Alfred's most famous and most successful writers, but he had a number of years in an editorial position here at Alfred. So he really is kind of, in my opinion, the father of Alfred Choral. And to me personally, when I was a choral conductor, I was conducting a lot of Jay's music with my high school kids. And when I got the opportunity to meet him and get to know him, I was sort of starstruck. And eventually, I started working side by side with him and had the honor of basically having Jay as my own mentor. So I love working with Jay. And he's such a great writer. And what I love about this piece is that it came from a place of pure emotional inspiration for Jay. So as the title says, he wrote it in 2020. The date that he has on the piece is April 13th of 2020. And if you think back to then, this was week 5 of quarantine. This was bad news coming every day about the death toll rising from COVID. Particularly the news in New York City was pretty grim at that time. And Jay has a note at the beginning of this explaining he went for a walk to sort of clear his mind of all this. And he got a beautiful reminder from Mother Nature with a bird singing three notes over and over. Over and over. And Jay sort of took this as a symbol of nature saying, like, this is in honor of those we've lost and in hopes for a better time. Jay took those three notes and built the opening melody here with the On You Stay text. And it's really turned out to be quite a special piece.
It's great. All right, let's listen.
On You Stay.
I really do love this piece. It seriously, it moves me to tears every time I listen to it. So,
yeah, and it's not difficult.
No, it's not. And I mean, obviously, the text is pretty simple.
It is.
It's just gorgeous.
It sounds very impressive. It's a great place for your choir to really express and, mm-hmm. and really put their heart into it. But it's not difficult to do. Mm-mm. Which is kind of the trick to Alfred's music and Jay Althaus being one of the major players there. Mm-hmm. You know, mm-hmm. what sounds like art includes great lessons, but is quite achievable.
Yeah, no, that's perfect. That's perfect. All right, let's move on. Tiger, Tiger, tell us about this one. Very interesting.
Yeah, well, first of all, it's a very cool poem by William Blake. It's sort of like feisty and fiery and agitated the way Tiger, Tiger might be. But really, I'm most excited about it because it's one of our newer composers, a female composer by the name of Katie O'Connor Ballantyne. Mm-hmm. Katie is just a brilliant musician, and I can speak about Katie because I've known her since she was in the eighth grade.
No way.
Yes, I was her high school choir teacher. And gosh, she sort of followed in my footsteps and went to Ithaca College and studied voice and choral conducting, got her master's. And when I came to Alfred to be a full-time writer-editor, she took my former job and taught at the high school where graduated from. And she's just developed into a top-notch educator and conductor and now a composer. This is not her first piece, but she's sort of an emerging artist in this realm. So I'm very excited to share her music.
She's still teaching right now then?
Yes.
And this is her fun job?
Yes. Yes. This is her way to express herself as a composer.
Oh, wow. Excellent. Well, okay. Tell us about this piece then.
Okay, so Tiger, Tiger, burning bright. It's very agitated, very sort of angular, the way you'd expect. You hear that sort of agitatedness in the words. Is that a word, agitatedness?
Sure.
Except for, you know, it's measure eight where the word becomes symmetry, and she really goes right to the beat. Symmetry, which I think is very, very cool. I'm all about text painting in our writing. When she gets to the refrain, it's more of a harmonic sequence that the singers get to sing. So it's somewhat predictable, but the chords are really flying by a few every measure. So it's very interesting and intriguing to hear, engaging. What I want to add one more thing. I forgot to talk about Katie as this consummate, amazing conductor and educator. She has prepared, and you can find this on our websites, a free PDF rehearsal guide that gives you exercises and approaches to really teach this piece from the very first introduction of the concepts in it to sort of the polishing just before performance. And that is such an invaluable resource. And when you read Katie's plan and words, you will know you're dealing with a master teacher here.
Oh, excellent. And we will link to that in the awesome. Description down below. I think that would be a great resource to have. All right, let's take a listen to this.
Tiger, 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 tiger. Tiger, 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 tiger. Scars burnt the fire of thine eyes. On what wings dare he aspire? What the hand dare seize the fire? And what shoulder and what heart could twist the sinews of thy heart? And when thy heart began to what the hammer, what the chain, in my fire.
Was great. And I know as I was listening to it to prep for our video today, I just from the title, I think I expected something a little simpler, like a little kid's tune. And then I heard it and it was just so complex and interesting. Yeah. And I really loved it. So
it really is. Yeah. Yes. And can I point out one other thing?
Yes.
I often hear from directors of SSA choirs that they always get to sing pretty slow songs, lyrical songs. This one comes SSA, so it's a very different SSA feature for those groups.
Excellent. Excellent. All right, let's move on to another one that is also based on some pretty heavy-duty literature, Stopping by Woods.
Yes. So it was only about a year ago when some of the famous poetry of Robert Frost entered the public domain, which now means...
Ah, that explains the infusion of Robert Frost.
Yeah, right? You're seeing a lot new Robert Frost settings because now all these contemporary writers can use those words for their own interpretation. And Ruth Morris Gray, who's a high school choral director out in Northern California, Ruth... Actually, not Northern California, L.A. area, north of L.A., I should say. Ruth has always been inspired by poetry, and I think she's been sort of sitting around for several years waiting for those Robert Frost poems to go into the public domain. And this is one of her first Robert Frost settings. What I like about it is that she approaches it as a problem solver teacher. So here's the problem that she has found. Many times when you pick an SAB or three-part mixed piece, the melody is so great, it has such a range, that the changing male voices in your choir can't really sing the melody. Mm-hmm. They've always got to sing some upper harmony or some other line, or they can only sing one phrase of the melody and then pass it off. And so she decided, can I create a melody that everybody can sing regardless of their voice change? And her main melody is just a perfect fourth in total. So she's really done it here.
Oh, wow.
So the guys sing the very first verse all by themselves in unison. Then there's a two-part treble second verse, very lovely. And of course, then three-part harmony as the piece progresses. It's also available for men's choirs, so that's a very nice touch. And it's got this very interesting treble voicing where it's two-part slash SSA.
Okay.
That slash means that there's going to be optional, those little Q notes in between. If you choose to sing them, you've got three-part treble. If you leave them out, it's just two-part treble. So very flexible no matter the development of your group.
So here we go with the three-part mixed version. Let's take a listen.
Whose words these are, I think I know. His house is in the village, though. He will not see me stopping here to watch his woods fill up with snow. My little horse must think it queer to stop without a farmhouse near, between the woods and frozen lake, the darkest evening of the year. He gives his horn, it spells a shame.
Gives his horn, it spells a shame.
Do ask if there is some mistake.
Ask if there is some mistake.
The only other sounds the sweet.
Only other sounds the sweet.
Of easy wind and downy flame.
That was just beautiful. I love it. So
yeah.
Let's move on to our last song in this first section. This is Umbrella, and I love this one too. Tell us about this one.
I'm glad that you love it. If you can't tell, I had a super fun time writing it. It was sort of, so I keep in a little folder down here up near my desk, ideas for future years. And I've written a number of youth choir pieces over the years, and they tend to be about an item in nature, or maybe even an inanimate object that I can wax poetic about. And on a little note to myself, for years in that drawer, I've had umbrella as a topic, which is, could it be a topic or not? It's questionable, but I decided to make it into one. Literally on a rainy day with my umbrella on my morning walk, I thought, what a useful tool. You know, it keeps us dry in the rain. If it's real sunny, it'll give us shade. The challenge here will be creating rhymes for the word umbrella. So I kind of made this just a hilarious time for myself, thinking of things like, okay, red or blue or yellow. It's a handy fella. It's stylish like Cinderella. At the end, there's even like a private joke to singers that we sing it a cappella. So that was really fun. And then I infused these moments for the singers to be a little dramatic in their performance, where you know how when you're thinking of something, you go, So I take the of umbrella. And each time a verse is beginning, the gets a little longer as the singers are thinking of the next clever set of rhymes.
Oh.
That's sort of the idea.
I didn't even catch that. I caught that there were but I didn't catch that they were getting longer each time.
They get longer each time. Not only that, it's fun to portray that, but it's also like, look, we can have longer phrases as the piece goes on. So for younger groups that are really working on breath control, that should come in handy. Can I add one more idea about this one? Don't ask me why I have drink umbrellas on my desk. I do.
It's a lovely prop. Come on, that's all
yeah,
it is.
Yeah, well, I mean, if you're a visual person like I am, umbrella choreography is easy and fun. Now, I picture your choir with full-size umbrellas. You know, they open up at the pop of a button. Boom, boom, right? And I don't have this specifically choreographed, but here are some ideas that would happen. You could, like, every two bars, open, then the next one's open, then the next one's open. So it takes like 16 or 24 bars to get all the umbrellas open, right? That's interesting. Then it's a waltz tempo, so they can all sort of sway side to side. You can assign ones and twos and go up and down every bar. That's always fun. The audience tends to love that. And then, of course, there's always this old standard, turn them forward and spin as you sing. So lots of visual things you can do with your full group or just some umbrella dancers out front.
Oh, yeah. And you know what? I wrote that down here. I can see choreography.
Oh, good.
I can see it because I was kind of moving when I was listening to it, too.
Yeah.
So, all right.
How often do you get to program sort of a waltz feel with
I know.
Your choir?
There's
this
so
is going
many...
to be something very different and fresh.
Yeah. And the kids will love this. All right. Let's take a listen and we'll come back and talk a little more at the end.
Umbrella.
Okay, so now that we've listened to it, I wonder how many times did you guys who are watching this, how many times did you laugh when you were listening to it? Because I was listening to it at my desk, and I have not openly laughed at a song that I was listening to in the longest time. I listen to a lot of music here. I was laughing. People came over and popped their head in my door. What are you doing? It was a great song. So,
oh, that's awesome. Thank you.
It's so great. I'm sure people will love this one. So highly recommended. Take a listen and see if you can visualize your kids doing umbrella choreography and laughing all at the same time. We all need that this year. So
yeah.
Yay.
Thank you.
It looks like we've got some pop stuff coming up. So let's start with It's All Right.
Yeah, It's All Right. You know, it's an awesome song to begin with by the great American singer-songwriter Curtis Mayfield. Mm-hmm. If you don't know Curtis Mayfield, he is well-known and influential in the world of soul music and really socially conscious African-American music. Mm. That's Curtis Mayfield. He wrote this song decades ago. Mm-hmm. More recently, the reason why it's important this year is that students have now seen Disney Pixar's movie Soul, that animated movie. It's so awesome, right? And John Batiste, who you know is the music director and band leader on the Stephen Colbert Show,
also amazing.
John realized his own soulful arrangement of the Mayfield tune here. So that's like two really authentic layers, right?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And then at Alfred, we gave it to our arranger, Robert T. Gibson, who's an African-American choral conductor who teaches the multicultural vocal ensemble at Missouri State University in Springfield. And Robert has a real sort of gospel history in his life, and he infused his rendition of this, influenced by both of those other men I mentioned, with lots of gospel harmonies.
Ah, okay, so this is not a direct transcription from the movie.
Well,
this
it's pretty darn close. Yeah. I have to say, it's pretty darn close, particularly if you were to look at the accompaniment.
Okay.
The movie is very piano-centric because the main character in there, Joe Gardner, is a piano player who actually, he's a middle school band director who wants to perform jazz on stage. I think that's pretty cool. But Joe's a piano player in the movie, so the piano part here is almost identical.
And it's very good. I had a note on here, piano part, love piano part, probably John Batiste.
yes, and super fun to play. Mm-hmm. But what Robert did was take what was basically a vocal duet and come up with some interesting ideas for more harmonies and more sort of gospel call and response sort of things that weren't in really what you're hearing in the movie.
Yeah, because that was not a choral piece, obviously.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, well, that clarifies, because I know it says at the top, inspired by this song. And so I just wanted to clarify that for the folks, what that actually meant. But it is very close. So, all right, let's take a listen.
Say it's all right. It's all right. Have a good time.
chance. Clap your hands, 'cause you've got soul.
You've got soul.
That song, it just makes me happy.
Yeah, you have to smile when you hear that.
You do. All right, moving on to another pop piece, pop/Broadway. Let's hear about Helpless.
Oh my gosh. Well, Helpless almost needs no introduction, right?
I mean,
it's Hamilton. Mm-hmm. We all love Hamilton. And Helpless is one of the greatest songs from the score. If you think about the story, this is sort of foreshadowing the marriage of Alexander Hamilton with Eliza Schuyler. There's little parts throughout Helpless where they're singing, I do, I do, I do, I do. That's foreshadowing the wedding mm-hmm. to come. Lisa Despain is just our favorite arranger for the Hamilton stuff. She is a New York City-based music theater educator. Ooh. She's a professional accompanist. I know she's worked with Lin-Manuel Miranda. And others in the field. So she's just absolutely authentically producing these arrangements from mm-hmm. Hamilton. And we're so excited to have Helpless this year.
This is great. All right, let's listen.
Everybody's dancing and the band's top volume.
Grind to the rhythm as you wine and dine. Grab my sister and whisper, you're this one's mine. Ooh.
My sister made her way across the room to you.
Ooh.
And I get nervous thinking what she gonna do.
Ooh.
She grabs her by the arm, I'm thinking I'm through.
Ooh.
And you look back at me and suddenly
brings out a different side of me. Peggy confides in me. Angelica tried to take a bite of me. No stress, my love for you is never in doubt. We'll get a little place in Harlem and we'll figure it out.
I've been living without a family since I was a child. My mother left, my mother died. I grew up but wild, but I'll never forget my mother's face that was real. And long as I'm alive, Eliza, swear to God, I'll never feel so helpless.
Eliza,
helpless.
I never felt so.
I'm
looking
to
the
eyes and the sky's the limit. I'm helpless.
I think the response to that might be, I've been waiting for that one.
Yeah, I mean, because there's a lot of Hamilton music out there, but this one's not out there yet.
That's so. Right.
And now right. It is. All right, let's move on. This one, I had to do a little investigating on this one. Hero, Mariah Carey, tell us about this.
Yeah, so why this that year was my first would question. We have done Hero, Mariah Carey? Well, I am a big fan of the Netflix series Schitt's Creek, S-C-H-I-T-T-S.
Correct, just, yes. Let's
so you don't clarify. Have to bleep me out in the
No,
end.
No, no.
I am a big fan of that show. And after wrapping the show, the actors on there, you know, there's a acapella group on the show. So there are some singers within that cast.
Okay.
And after wrapping the show, in honor of the graduating class of 2020, the cast regrouped for their own virtual choir that you can find on YouTube. And what they wanted to sing to the graduates that year was Hero. Now, their music supervisor for the Netflix series was this guy named Aaron Jensen, and Aaron arranged this arrangement for them. So when you're looking at the bass part, that's what Eugene Levy sings.
Really? This is the exact arrangement?
Oh, yeah. When you're looking at the tenor part, that's what David, the character, is singing on there. So, yeah, this is real legit what they sang. You can find them performing it on YouTube with a special surprise appearance of Mariah at the very end.
Oh my
she
gosh.
Appears on a screen and sort of improvises some riffs over the top like only she would, you know?
Well, we'll link to that too down at the bottom.
Yeah.
We'll find out.
Oh, yeah,
that
would be it's so sure, fun to fun. See. So fans of that show are going to absolutely love that. Not only that, you know, this is a really beautiful song. It works great to honor our everyday heroes. Mm-hmm. And after the year we've had, haven't we really identified some amazing heroes in our lives? Mm-hmm. And I do want to shout out to Brian Sharp, our arranger, who adapted Aaron's version here for publications so that it fits a traditional school choir.
Yeah. All right. Let's listen.
There's a hero. If you look inside your heart, you don't have to be afraid of what you are. There's an answer. If you reach into your soul, and the sorrow that you know will melt away. Comes along with the strength to carry on, and you cast your fears aside, and you know you can survive. 'Cause when you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong, and you'll finally see the truth that a hero lies in you. Lord knows dreams are hard to follow, but don't let anyone tear them away. Yeah. Hold on, there will be tomorrow. In time, you'll find a way. Strength to carry on, and you cast your fears aside, and you know you can survive. 'Cause when you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong, and you'll finally see the truth that a hero lies. A hero lies, a hero lies, a hero that a hero lies in you.
Okay, let's move on for a total change of pace. Let's do
we are changing the
velvet pace. Shoes. Tell us about this.
So I have been a longtime fan of this poem by Eleanor Wiley, Velvet Shoes, and I've wanted to do a setting. And when I got to really working on the piece, I decided to sort of take motives from the text and turn them into musical motives. So this isn't every single word verbatim, but sort of ideas like walking and trotting with velvet shoes. And I create sort of a harmonic motive where there's a pedal tone going on and chords sort of moving up and down over that pedal tone. That's sort of the gentle walk. The main melody is comes from above. We shall walk is how each verse starts. And that's like the falling snow from above to create the velvet snow. You'll hear a piano motive that's kind of disjunct and very large intervals. I'm trying to create, the text talks about lacy snow, icy laciness. And that's sort of what I'm trying to paint with that piano motive that comes in and out. Trying to think if there's anything else, Andrea. I'm just really big on word painting and representative music. One of the very obvious ones, and students will instantly pick up on this one, is the text that talks about we're going uphill and down, and you can hear that clearly in the melody and the harmonies.
So there's a lot that teachers could talk about with this piece, in addition to just singing the notes.
I hope so, and I really hope it's a piece that you'll dig into way more than the notes and get to the expressive qualities, the syllabic stress, the rise and fall of the phrase, the ebb and flow of rubato, all these things that we want to do to develop the complete choral musician can be extracted in this piece.
Oh, excellent. All right, let's listen. Velvet Shoes.
We shall walk in velvet shoes. We shall trot all over town. We shall walk in velvet shoes. Tranquil pace.
Our last piece, and this is another one that I just love, a perfect closer, A New Horizon.
A New Horizon is, well, my friend Greg Gilpin, and one of everyone's favorite mm-hmm. composers, I feel like this is his little pep talk for us after what has been sort of a bleak past in the recent past. We are on the precipice of something much brighter. We're on a new horizon, looking to a brighter day. Greg says everything will be all right. Everything's going to be okay as we move to the future. And I really love that message. I think that's so important for us to have positive messages in our choral rooms. Mm-hmm. We spend most of our time in choir in rehearsal, right? Mm-hmm. And very little in performance. I think framing your rehearsal for positive, uplifting feelings is so important. You're going to mm-hmm. sing this song dozens, tens, hundreds maybe of times as you work toward the performance. Make it be a text that really uplifts the spirit of your group.
Yeah. Yep. Go ahead.
Go ahead, Andrea.
I was going to say, and no one writes uplifting texts like Greg.
He does a great job.
It's good. It's really good.
He chose stylistically here, the music has somewhat of a gospel mm-hmm. flavor. So he's used some of the gospel conventions, like a rhythmic feel that's characteristically gospel. He's got a great opening solo that becomes a duet. There are some wonderful traditional gospel sonorities, inversions that grow higher as the refrain unfolds. That's a very gospel technique, as well as articulations. Many times short notes that contrast the long big chords are really a good characterization of that style. So when you see those staccatos and you're performing this, really do create space after the notes.
Okay. All right, let's listen. A New Horizon.
I can see a new horizon on a brand new day.
I can see the sun arising, showing me the way. And everything will be alright, everything will be okay. 'Cause I can see a new horizon on a brand new day.
Thank you.
Excellent. Thanks for taking us on a tour of 10 of the new Alfred titles this year.
It was absolutely my pleasure. And yeah. Thank you so much for the opportunity.
You bet. You bet. Are there any parting words you would like to give our viewers today?
Well, I think, yeah, I wasn't prepared to do this, but yes.
I know. I just throw this in to everyone. Just...
I mean, I think that we are, I kind of said it when we were talking about Greg's last piece there. We are on the precipice of a brighter day. It's been so long since we could gather and sing and make music, and we might still be doing that with distance, we might still be doing that with masks for our safety, depending on what happens over the next several months. Mm-hmm. But you know what the quarantine and the pandemic couldn't do? They couldn't stop the music in our soul. It's been here all year, and how glorious it will be when we get back together and share it with our fellow musicians. I wish everyone the greatest recovery and the most joy. This year is going to be about joy as you come back together for your music making.
Oh, it sure is. Very well said.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Andy. We really appreciate your time. And we know we're going to be seeing you out this year on the convention circuit. So we're excited to get back to it. So
yes, I look forward to interacting with everybody face to face at a convention soon.
Indeed. All right. Well, thank you so much. We appreciate
it. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye. We hope you found this video helpful. We know that picking new music can be tough, and we're here to help. If you did find it helpful, please give us a thumbs up and be sure to comment below to let us know of any ideas you want to see in future episodes. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any new content we have coming out at JW Pepper. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.